Hi everyone, and welcome back to Creative PowerPoint. Today, we'll see together how to turn a blank slide into a textile background, add some dyed text, and turn any image into a stitched image. As a bonus, we'll see a variation with hand-stitched text. Let's make the textile background. Right-click on an empty slide, select Format Background, and set the background color of your choice. In my case, I've chosen a two-color gradient. Let's add the textile texture. On Pixabay, I've downloaded this image of a textile. I'll give the link in the video description. Let's insert the image on our slide. We want to use the color information from our background and the texture information from the textile image. To do so, in the Image Format panel, let's lower the saturation to 0 to turn it into a black and white image. Let's also increase the transparency to about 80%. Let's make sure the image covers the full slide. Our background is now complete. Let's add the dyed text. Let's insert a text box. I'm using the typeface Forte. Let's set the gradient fill. And let's add a white outline. As previously, we want to use the color information from the text and the texture information from the textile image. To do so, let's move our text to the back of the slide. If you rather want a hand-stitched effect, you can use a hand-stitched typeface. I'm using Satin Stitched. I'll give the link in the video description. Now it's time to stitch our image to the textile. I've got this image of a PowerPoint logo with a white outline. As previously, we want to use the color information from the logo and the texture information from the textile image. Let's move our logo to the back of the slide. It's already interesting, but it doesn't look like the logo is stitched. Rather, it looks like it's dyed on the textile. To give a stitched effect, we need to add some irregularities to the logo. Depending on the image, you can use one of these two methods. Let's try the first method. Let's go to the Picture Artistic Effects, add a glass effect. Set the scaling to 0 and the transparency to about 80%. The second method works well if you have an image with large areas of homogeneous colors. Go to the Picture Artistic Effect, and instead of the glass effect, use the marker effect. Set the size to 100 and leave transparency at 0%. Which method do you prefer? Here's the final result. Somewhere in 1395, Sir Bradley is giving a PowerPoint presentation.
And here, my lord, is how we can increase our market share. Next slide. Any questions?